Hi, I'm Pete Allen, Unit Leader of Level Design Fundamentals, which is a second semester game design unit. In Level Design Fundamentals, we'll be going over all aspects of a level's creation, from the initial concept and concept art gathering stages, to layout, meshes, lighting, all the way through to having a fully detailed working level with mechanics and gameplay and everything that you would expect. Now, there's obviously a lot more there than I can cover in this quick introduction video, so what I'm going to do today is just give you a quick overview of maybe three or four of the key concept areas that we're going to look at, starting with level layout. After the initial concept work has been done, a level designer might start to think about the layout of the level. Now, of course, this is going to differ greatly depending on the genre and game mode, so let's use a simple objective-based team map such as a Counter-Strike bomb defusal style map as an example here. We might start thinking about our layout with a simple top-down line diagram like this one, which shows two spawn points with lines representing pathways that lead in between them. Now, as you can see, there are three main routes players could take from the lower spawn to the top one, and if we say that the lower spawn is where the attackers spawn and the spawn at the top of the image is where defenders spawn, we would place the defensive positions, shown here by these X's, closer to the defending spawn so they can get there quickly and set up. And we've also added in a few more paths to help them get there. We can already see where combat is likely to take place, where there are choke points on this map, as players are likely to run into each other, so those areas would need to be very carefully thought out. And maybe we need some pathways running across the map horizontally as we're looking at it, to allow players to switch between those three main routes and, you know, provide a bit more variety. That's a rough idea of how we might start planning the layout for that particular playstyle of map, but there are other design considerations that I didn't get into, like building good defensive positions, managing lines of sight, placing cover, and many more. And this is before we start to talk about, well, what if it's a different playstyle of map altogether, like a different multiplayer mode or even a campaign map, each of which have their own design considerations, which we will get into in the unit. The next key concept that I want to talk about briefly is something called blocking out, sometimes known as white boxing or grey boxing. This is the process of building a 3D level's layout from very simple geometry that is easy to work with and quick to modify. Now, blocking out is an industry standard technique, although not every developer is happy to release images of their levels when they were at this very early stage in development. But that being said, you can sometimes find images online of some levels from some quite well-known games when those levels were at this very early stage, such as these images from Uncharted 4, Titanfall, and Killzone Mercenary. And there are other similar images online if you have a little look around. So the last key concept I want to talk about here is our mesh placement. This will typically be done in stages, starting with the basic structural stuff that makes up the bulk of the level's actual layout. Then we might do another pass for some of the other large-scale structure that enhances the layout, like these overhead beams here. Next pass, we might add in some gameplay affecting meshes, like items of cover, or to build specific encounter points, and so on. For a final mesh pass, we might add all the little clutter and decoration items that don't really affect gameplay in any way but just enhance the look and feel of the level, like stones on the ground or leaves, or things like the rails in the lower part of this image here. So that's a quick introduction to three of the key concepts that we're going to cover in LDF. There are many more that I just don't have time to get into in this brief introduction video. The tool that we're going to be using in LDF is Unreal Engine. Now, Unreal Engine 5 will become available at some point during Semester 2, not quite sure when yet, so we're going to start with Unreal Engine 4, and then when UE5 comes out, I will run some special UE5 focus sessions to bring you guys up to speed with that. Now, this brings me to an important point about video game development and the associated hardware and software. We are currently at the start of the 9th generation of gaming, and it is important to understand that there is a history to this. These new devices and engines clearly did not just arrive out of nowhere, but rather are an improvement on things that occurred in the previous generation, which in turn was an improvement on the generation before that, and so on, all the way back really to the 1960s, where we find the unofficial Generation Zero. Going over this history is important so that you guys get an understanding of why tools like Unreal Engine work the way that they do, why game development in general is the way that it is. So what we're going to do for the first 3 weeks of LDF, we'll have an extra lecture per week where we'll go through some of this history. We'll look at some of the key things that have happened over the 9 generations, well, 10 if you count the unofficial Generation Zero. We'll see how each generation has changed the way level design is, changed the way video game development is, what new things each generation has brought to the table, so that you understand why things are the way they are here at the start of Generation 9, where unfortunately at the moment, some Generation 9 hardware seems to be particularly tricky to get hold of. So I hope you guys found that quick introduction to LDF useful. There's a lot more that I don't have time to get into here, but I'll see you for the unit in Semester 2 anyway. That is if I don't see you before in some of your labs for your Semester 1 units. Thanks for watching.